Hey, welcome back. Now, as parents, we know how important education is for our keiki, and many look towards an independent school education.
Yeah, that's right. The Hawaii Association of Independent Schools can help you find the right school for your child. Now, this is really cool. I actually got to talk to Robert Landau, the executive director. He gave me a little insight on some of the admission fairs coming up that you should attend. Okay, I'm joined by Robert Landau, the executive director of the Hawaii Association for Independent Schools. Aloha, how you doing, sir?
I'm doing very well today. Thanks for having me.
I gotta ask, if anybody doesn't know, what is the Hawaii Association of Independent Schools, and how large is your organization, sir?
Well, we have 93 independent schools from across the state. Mm-hmm. We provide services to schools, to parents, to students, to teachers, through professional development, information, collaboration, where we bring people together in professional development situations, and we advocate on behalf of independent schools across the state.
That's awesome. Now, I also know you have some great admission fairs, right? Now, there are going to be a couple coming up, especially this weekend, the Honolulu Fair on Saturday at the Japanese Cultural Center, also the Leeward Fair on Tuesday, September 29th at the Pearl Country Club, and don't forget about the Windward Side on Thursday, October 1st at the Ko'olau Ballrooms. I got to ask, what is an admission fair? If everyone's ever been to one, what can people expect?
Okay, so you're going to have the opportunity to meet many of our schools. These are parents who are looking potentially for independent school education as an option for their children. And you know, it's really important that you almost shop for schools, because your children are different. Mm-hmm. Different learning styles, different expectations, different attitudes about school. And so you really need to talk to a school first before you decide that that's the school that's the best right fit for your student.
And, you know, and parents, you know, you hopefully know your kids' learning styles, but it's not only learning though, right? Because schools, it comes to the athletic aspect, the social, I mean, arts, so many things change with school now, and the kids hopefully change along with them, right?
Well, look, I'm coming off 25 years of being a school head. I've been a head of school with 137 students, mm-hmm, and 4,000 students.
Wow.
So big schools have options. Small schools are great for some kids who really want to be known by the school and may have more opportunities than they'll have in a big school. So you really have to know your child. Understand what the school is offering you and just find that right fit.
I gotta ask, I don't want to say there's going to be so many people there and so many, it shouldn't be something people should be intimidated, right? I mean, this is going to be an information session. Come in, have questions. Nothing people should be like, oh my gosh, there's so much going on, right?
Look, this is the most important decision you're going to make for your child, choosing a school. Mm-hmm. Because that child's going to be in that school potentially for 10, 12 years. Mm-hmm. So, no, you're going to be talking with admissions directors. They love to talk about their school. They love to talk about the right fit for your child. The options in their school for the arts, for music, for sports, for athletics, mm-hmm, and all kinds of different options.
Forgive me for asking, but you know, on the parent side, you know, you're talking about admissions director, especially in some schools it can be competitive. Do the parents need to almost dress themselves up, get ready, and almost like a job interview, and present themselves and ask the right questions as well? Is there pressure in that sense, sir? Or what would be the best way to say that?
You know, to be honest, the parent and the child are the future clients. Mm. The schools are there to, of course, put their right foot forward and to make a great impression, but it's a question of choice. So, no, I don't think there's a dress code, mm-hmm, mm-hmm, and you're going to be meeting educators who have children, number one, in their best interest.
Oh, that's a great idea. And you have something kind of new that you're introducing and bringing around, kind of a global thing. Talk about this and what people can expect with this new thing you're bringing. What's
it
called?
Thank you for asking.
Yeah.
First of all, I'm new. I'm new to Hawaii. I have been overseas for nearly 40 years, mm-hmm, just moving from Singapore, Cambodia, China. So I'm bringing to this job an international and global perspective. And one of the first things we're going to introduce is called the Global Issues Network. Okay. There are already schools around the world that are focusing on 20 key issues, okay, that are facing our children's future.
Wow.
And the Global Issue Network focuses on these 20 issues locally. So we're going to look at issues like poverty, water, deforestation, fisheries, e-commerce, copyright laws. We get students to focus on an issue, how it applies here in Hawaii. But the great thing about the Global Issues Network, they now have colleagues, student colleagues around the world who are facing those issues in their country.
Wow.
Could be Guatemala, could be China, could be Sweden, could be Mozambique.
Uh-huh.
And we're planning to host the first Global Issues Network conference in Hawaii next school year, 2016-17. Wow. And you know, and it's so sad, the world is getting smaller and smaller, and the students being able to learn from other students around the world, that must be such an invaluable opportunity. I mean, it's a wonderful opportunity. It's key because it's a question of creating a network around these issues that are going to impact our students' future. But having this global perspective when you're talking to students from different countries without them ever coming here or us going there.
Amazing. Robert, thank you so much for all this information. Great things. And again, a parent, family, Kapun out there, we'll have all the information on our website. But again, you've got to head down, because if you want to go to one place and ask all these important questions for the future of our keiki, this is the place to be.
And as we mentioned, there are actually three admission fairs you can attend, and all three fairs, they have breakout sessions for families to talk and understand how to finance private school. Yeah, we were chatting during the break about that. A lot of parents don't realize that private school can actually be very affordable if you
on a month-to-month basis.
Yes, no, but yeah, there's grants, there's finance packages out there that can really, really help you.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's right. And the HAIS also sponsors the Schools of the Future Conference, which will take place November 3rd and 4th at the Hawaii Convention Center. It's presented by the HAIS DOE and Hawaii Community Foundation in partnership with the Pillars of Peace Fund and the Hawaii Society for Technology and Education.
Nice.
Now, educators and administrators may go to this conference, and it will feature three renowned keynote speakers. They'll share their best practices and create new learning environments.
Yeah.
It's a big one.
You know, and it's so important. And as my young sixth grade teacher always says, Tyzo, there's no stupid question. Go to these admissions fairs. They're welcoming. There is any question, whether it's about pickup times, what kids wear to school, the financial parts, school lunch, they'll answer those questions to really help allay your fears or concerns that you have with your education for kids.
I'll be there.
Yeah.